The light shining into this cockpit is not from a floodlight. It's actually from a laser pointer. This video, produced for the U.S. Air Force and the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, shows how dangerous it is for pilots when people point lasers at airplanes, jets, or helicopters.
The time it gets up to us at 1,000 feet, it is a lot bigger than it looks like at night, not just a pinpoint. So as it hits that plexiglass, the light disperses more throughout the cockpit.
At an FBI news conference, St. Louis Metropolitan Police Officer Doug Reinholds talked about how disorientating it was when he and his partner were lasered while on night patrol in a helicopter.
And it's equivalent to like a flash of a camera if you were in a pitch black car, you know, at night. So it's a temporarily blinding to the pilot, also to the tactical flight officer, whoever we're with.
Justin Stouter of suburban St. Louis pointed the laser. It took only minutes for officers to find and arrest him.
I guess I'll give a public apology to the pilot.
Stouter was aiming the laser at a distant tower from his yard when the police helicopter appeared in the line of sight about a mile and a half away.
You know, it started off just admiring the laser and shining it and seeing how far it'd go and what it hit. And the helicopter flew by, and I made the decision to see if it would reach the helicopter, and obviously it did. But viewing the video, I had no idea that it, you know, illuminated the whole cockpit and blinded, you know, everyone inside.
In 2010, there were more than 2,800 reported laser incidents nationwide. That's the most since the FAA started keeping track in 2005.
Pointing a laser like this at an aircraft is not a harmless prank. We take this seriously. These people standing here represent almost a dozen agencies that formed the St. Louis Laser Strike Working Group to combat this problem.
There haven't been any accidents from laser strikes, mainly because of the skill of the pilots, but it has caused pilots to temporarily divert from their missions.
Imagine that you are in critical condition and a medical helicopter is responding to the call, but your pilot responding to you had to divert after being temporarily blinded by a laser. That's a problem when you have a medical emergency and seconds and minutes count.
If you point a laser and interfere with the operation of an aircraft, that's a felony. The crime carries a maximum of 20 years in federal prison and $250,000 fine. In addition, the FAA can impose a civil penalty of $11,000 maximum for each violation. Stouter completed a one-year pretrial diversion program, which is offered to eligible offenders who agree to follow terms and conditions of supervision and probation. After successful completion, the U.S. Attorney's Office agrees to not pursue charges.
He is here today because he wants others to learn from his mistake. I applaud him for his courage to be here.
Even though Stouter will not be prosecuted, he lost two career opportunities during probation.
So it was really a selfish mistake. You know, I don't know if the pilot has children, but if that aircraft would have went down, it would affect so many people aside from myself.